News Hour at 9, co-powered by Cisco. Light years ahead.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's 9 p.m. and we have a special edition of the News Hour tonight. We'll give you the biggest survey and the biggest numbers on the Gujarat polls on the day. The Election Commission has announced 9th and 14th December as the dates of polling in Gujarat. The most definitive and exhaustive opinion survey on the BJP's prospects in Gujarat on a day when the Election Commission has made these announcements for polling in the state. Our survey and our cephalologist, Jayam Rogge, will be testifying to this based on a sample size of 6,000 respondents spread over across 8 regions of the state. The survey has a margin of error of plus minus 3%. Without wasting any time, let's take you through to the numbers. But ladies and gentlemen, the hashtag is Gujarat Modi Verdict. So send us your questions, send us your tweets on that big hashtag. The numbers that we all have been waiting for are here. And joining me is my colleague, Anand Narasimhan. Anand, what's the vote share? Let's give our viewers the vote share first. What's
well,
the vote share that our survey,
Navika,
the Times
the
Now
Gujarat
VMR
polls.
Survey is projecting?
True. And the question is, who will win the Gujarat polls? And we first, let's just tease the vote shares. Why don't we? 2017, the numbers are here. Who will win the Gujarat polls? BJP 52%, the Congress 37%, and the others 11%. That's what the numbers are, Navika. And if you compare that with 2014 and 2012,
well, the numbers in 2012 were 48% for the BJP. So the BJP improves its tally to 52, 4% increase in the BJP's vote share, 39% to the Congress party in 2012. That goes down to 37%. And the others who had 13% go down to 11%. And look at how this stacked up in 2014. 60%. That was the Narendra Modi magic that was working. 60% was the BJP's tally. It's down from that level in 2014. But then those were central Lok Sabha elections. These are assembly elections, and the BJP has anti-incumbency, but it still improves its vote share margin by 4%. And the Congress party in the elections of the Lok Sabha in 2014 had a vote share of 33%, which improved to 37%. The others had 7% in 2014. But the big numbers, the seat share, yes, that's what our viewers are waiting for. Anand, over to you. Take the projection of the seat share.
Absolutely. And the seats are very, very clear. And if they're going to have a 4% bump compared to 2012, then the higher end should be more than the 120 that they got in 2012. So the upper end of this trajectory for the BJP is 134. Otherwise, they will hover around somewhere close to their 2012 number. So they still are in the clear. The Congress party, 49 to 61, and others 0 to 3. So very clearly, they will either repeat their performance of 2012, the BJP, or they will do better.
Well, and let's compare this with 2012. 115 was the tally of the BJP with an improvement of 4% of the vote share. The BJP is set to get anything between 118 and 134 seats in Gujarat. So what happens to Rahul Gandhi and all his cowboys that he's got around him, Jignesh Mewani, Alpesh Thakur, as well as Hardik Patel? What's happening there? There is a boomerang factor that our survey shows. It shows that Alpesh Thakur's vote base actually contradicts with the vote base of Hardik Patel. Is that the reason why there are actually surreptitious meetings and not above board meetings between Hardik Patel and Rahul Gandhi? Is it all a silent game? because 61 seats for the Congress Party in 2012, now they're slated to get anything between 49 and 61. This is, of course, much better than their Lok Sabha performance of 17. But for the BJP, the Lok Sabha performance was 165. If you map the Lok Sabha to the assembly segments in 2017, the BJP is a little down. But then that was the magic of Modi in 2014. And now we are looking at these numbers for the BJP in the clear up, bettering their performance of 2012. And let me go back to Mr. Vijay Rupani, the Chief Minister of Gujarat, who's still with us on the News Hour tonight. Mr. Rupani, our survey says aapko 118 se 134 tak seats aayengi. Aapne to 160, 165 kaha tha. Aapko lagta hai ye aapke anuman se kam hai?
Actually, Uttar Pradesh mein bhi sabhi logon ne, aap logon ne jo survey kiya tha, kisi ne bhi 325 कहा नहीं था, और मिली भी है. उत्तराखंड में भी ज्यादा मिली है, इस तरीके से गुजरात में भी ज्यादा मिलेगी.
देखिए,
वेल द जीएसटी, या राहुल, यू कैन आस्क.
यू नो नाविका, आई न्यू दिस वाज गोइंग टू बी ड्रेज्ड अप. बट रूपानी साहब, जीएसटी डीमो जो राहुल गांधी बुलाते हैं, गब्बर सिंह टैक्स, वो कह रहे हैं कि वो आपको काफी दिक्कत दे रहा है अर्बन एरियाज में स्पेसिफिकली. और दीज इनिशिएटिव्स हैव ऑल्सो ड्रॉन राहुल गांधी, हार्दिक पटेल एंड द अल्पेश टुगेदर. एंड सम वुड से दिस इज अ फेलियर ऑन योर पार्ट, सर, टू एंटिसिपेट दिस काइंड ऑफ एंटी बीजेपी पोलराइजेशन.
नहीं, एक्चुअली क्या है आपको बताऊं मैं. पहले तो जीएसटी के बारे में, कि गुजरात के, गुजरात व्यापारी स्टेट है. गुजरात के व्यापारी, इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट, किसी ने भी जीएसटी का विरोध नहीं किया है. सभी ने जीएसटी का स्वीकार किया है. सब चाहते थे कि भाई ये तो 10 साल लेट हुआ कि जीएसटी वन टैक्स, 12-12, 15-15 डिपार्टमेंट को डील करने के बदले एक डिपार्टमेंट और पूरे देश में एक प्राइस हो. इसके लिए सबने स्वागत किया है. लेकिन कोई भी नई सिस्टम आती है तो नेचुरली 6 महीना सेट होते उसमें धीरे धीरे सेट होती है. तो नरेंद्र भाई ने उस वक्त भी बताया था कि 3 महीने के बाद हम रिव्यू करेंगे, जितना जितना प्रॉब्लम होगा उसको हम सॉल्व करेंगे. और धीरे धीरे सॉल्व हो रहा है. गत 6 अक्टूबर को जीएसटी काउंसिल ने बहुत सारे प्रश्नों को सॉल्व किया है. कल जेटली जी ने भी जो घोषणा की, इससे भी लाभ हुआ है. बाकी जो थोड़े बहुत प्रश्न होंगे वो भी हम सेट कर देंगे.
The Congress, Mr. Rupani, has revived the Kham Alliance. There has never been a caste consolidation of this kind since Madhav Singh Solanki's time. Who is to blame? Did आपकी सरकार ने क्या ये देखने से अपने आप को रोक लिया? हार्दिक पटेल, अल्पेश ठाकुर, जिग्नेश मेवानी सब इकट्ठे हो गए, आप अकेले पड़ गए. क्या इससे भी आपको लगता है कि आप निकाल लेंगे ये इलेक्शन?
हेलो, मैं आपको मैं इसके बारे में बताऊं कि हम तो पहले से कह रहे हैं, 2 साल से कह रहे हैं कि अल्पेश, हार्दिक और जिग्नेश एक कांग्रेस के ही एजेंट है, कांग्रेस के ही कार्यकर्ता है, कांग्रेस का ही षड्यंत्र था आंदोलन चलाना. लेकिन अल्पेश और हार्दिक और जिग्नेश ने समाज को इतना बताया था कि नहीं, हम सौगंध खाते हैं कि हम कोई पॉलिटिक्स नहीं करने वाले हैं, हम किसी पार्टी में जाने वाले नहीं है. लेकिन अब ये हो गया, अल्पेश की इतनी वीडियो वायरल हुई है, वो सौगंध खाता है कि मैं पॉलिटिक्स में नहीं जाऊंगा, किसी पार्टी ज्वाइंट नहीं करूंगा, चुनाव नहीं लड़ूंगा, और कांग्रेस ज्वाइंट किया. इसलिए आज लोग उस पर नाराज है और लोग उनको ड्यूअल एंटिटी और दूसरा चेहरा भी लोगों ने देख लिया. अल्पेश, एक मिनट, अल्पेश पहले भी कांग्रेस के पंचायत का चुनाव कांग्रेस के सिंबल पर लड़ा था, वो भी एक्सपोज हो गया. अल्पेश के पिताजी आज भी कांग्रेस के डिस्ट्रिक्ट के प्रेसिडेंट हैं.
ओके,
तो उनके समाज में ही उनके खिलाफ आज वातावरण खड़ा हो गया है। दूसरी बात आपको बताऊं।
All right, Mr. Rupani, thank you very much for responding to the survey and the findings. The first survey on Gujarat that we put up here, the majority goes to the BJP. It seems like a sealed battle. Is it going to go the Uttar Pradesh way? Thank you very much, Mr. Vijay Rupani, for joining me. As I open up this debate with the numbers on your screen, I'm joined by Sudhanshu Trivedi, national spokesperson of the BJP, Ghanshyam Tiwari, national spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party, Dr. Fuad Haleem, national spokesperson of the CPIM, Alimuddin Khan, political analyst, Saba Naqvi, senior journalist, Kumar Ketkar, senior journalist, and Jay Mrug, our in-house sophologist, continues to be with us. But my first question goes to Mr. Alimuddin Khan. Alimuddin Khan, bahut raat-raat ki meetings ho rahi hain. 5-star होटल में रूम नंबर 224 में हार्दिक पटेल जाते हैं, राहुल गांधी जाते हैं, छुप छुप के क्यों मिल रहे हैं अलीमुद्दीन खान? रिजल्ट तो ये है दैट द कॉन्ट्रडिक्टरी वोट ऑफ अल्पेश ठाकुर एंड हार्दिक पटेल इज एक्चुअली सिंकिंग द कांग्रेस।
नविका जी, अल्पेश ठाकुर जी की कम्युनिटी की 40% वोट्स हैं और जो हार्दिक पटेल जी की 20% वोट्स है, 60% वोट तो यही बनता है जिनको ये बोल रहे हैं रूपानी जी कि उनका कोई वहाँ पर स्टेक नहीं है गुजरात में। अगर पटेल कम्युनिटी का और ओबीसी कम्युनिटी का अगर वहाँ स्टेक नहीं है तो क्या फिर जैन कम्युनिटी का वहाँ पर स्टेक है, जहाँ पर 69 कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी नंबर 69
राजकोट वेस्ट
Mr. Rupani is going to lose. Mr. Rupani is going to be defeated himself. He knows this.
Navika ji,
छुप छुप के मिलने की जरूरत तो इनको है। अगर अल्पेश ठाकुर सुनिए, अगर अल्पेश ठाकुर हार्दिक पटेल इंपोर्टेंट नहीं है गुजरात में तो उनके खिलाफ नॉन अवेलेबल वारंट क्यों होते हैं? उनके 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 खिलाफ कैमरे क्यों उतारे जाते हैं?
नॉन अवेलेबल वारंट कोर्ट देती है।
उनके खिलाफ इंटेलिजेंस और सीआईबी लगाई सीआईडी लगाई जाती है बिकॉज दे हैव इंपोर्टेंस देयर। That's why BJP government is after them.
Okay, Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi.
देखिए अलीमुद्दीन खान साहब जो बोल रहे हैं, मुलाकातें तो हो रही हैं पर छुपाई भी जा रही हैं। मिलना भी जरूरी है पर उससे राज को छुपाना भी जरूरी है। मतलब मिलो ना तुम तो हम घबराएं, मिलो तो आग चुराएं, हमें क्या हो गया है। और साहब मैं बिल्कुल मानता हूं कि वो लोग इंपॉर्टेंट हैं। हार्दिक का भी प्रभाव है, जिग्नेश का भी प्रभाव है, अल्पेश का भी प्रभाव है, तो भैया राहुल गांधी का कहां पे प्रभाव है? राहुल गांधी उनके आगे काहे झोली फैलाए हुए हैं? और मैं फिर ये बात कहना चाहता हूं कि समस्या क्या है, राहुल गांधी जी बेचारे जिस युवा के साथ हाथ मिला लेते हैं उसकी पता नहीं क्या गति हो
जाती है। आप देखिए,
अरे सुन लीजिए जनाब, कश्मीर में उमर अब्दुल्ला के साथ हाथ मिलाया था युवा ने, क्या हुआ? उत्तर प्रदेश में अखिलेश यादव के साथ मिलाया, क्या हुआ? यहाँ पे इन तीनों के साथ हाथ मिलाया है तो क्या हुआ है? इसलिए आप बिल्कुल आश्वस्त रहिए, अगर सर्वेक्षण को देख करीब बाय लुकिंग इनटू सर्वे इज दैट यू आर नॉट एबल टू रियलाइज द रियलिटी।
यू हैव सर्वे इट इज अप टू यू बट यू डोंट वांट टू डिस्क्लोज इट।
नाविका, आई एम एस्टोनिश्ड दैट हाउ अ पर्सन हु इज बैसाकी ऑफ यूपी विद यू रिप्रेजेंटिंग कांग्रेस पार्टी इज टॉकिंग डायरेक्टली अबाउट बिजनेसमैन कि ये कम्युनिटी है या वो कम्युनिटी है?
बिकॉज ऑफ द जीएसटी,
दिस इज अनफॉर्चुनेट,
बिकॉज ऑफ द डिमोनेटाइजेशन
दैट ऑल दोस पॉलिटिकल पार्टी एंड पर्टिकुलरली पॉलिटिकल पार्टी व्हिच इज कॉल्ड द ग्रैंड पॉलिटिकल पार्टी ऑफ इंडिया, दे ओपनली टॉक अबाउट कास्ट। कहीं खाम की बात करते थे गुजरात
yes.
तो कभी अजगर की बात होती थी उत्तर प्रदेश में, तो कभी बिहार में एमवाई की बात होती थी। इस तरह की जातिगत संरचनाओं के बाद ही आपकी वह गति से दुर्गति हुई है। स्टिल यू आर टॉकिंग सो ओपनली और मुलाकातें।
ऑल राइट, जेम रोग और राम टेम्पल, जेम रोग आर सेफोलॉजिस्ट, लेट्स गेट इन आर सेफोलॉजिस्ट
मिस्टर अलीमुद्दीन खान।
जेम रोग
राम मंदिर पे
लोग समझ गए हैं कि धर्म की राजनीति में कुछ नहीं है।
मिस्टर पालीमोदी
खान पता है, लोगों को पता है सर।
जयम रोग कैन यू एक्सप्लेन टू अलीमुद्दीन खान जी, अलीमुद्दीन खान जी इतना बौखलाने की जरूरत नहीं है, ये सर्वे है। अलीमुद्दीन खान साहब, अलीमुद्दीन खान साहब इतना मत बौखलाइए, किसी और को भी बोलने दीजिए। जयम रोग, माय क्वेश्चन टू यू सिंपली इज, कैन वी पुट डाउन द फेडर ऑफ मिस्टर अलीमुद्दीन खान बिकॉज ही कांट स्टॉप टॉकिंग। मिस्टर जयम रोग, माई क्वेश्चन टू यू इज, डिस्पाइट द कास्ट कॉम्बिनेशन, द कास्ट काउबॉयज एज वी आर कॉलिंग देम, हार्दिक पटेल, जिग्नेश मेवानी एज वेल एज अल्पेश ठाकुर कमिंग टूगेदर विद द कांग्रेस पार्टी विद राहुल गांधी, हाउ इज द अरिथमेटिक एक्चुअली नॉट वर्किंग फॉर द कांग्रेस पार्टी? एक्सप्लेन टू आवर व्यूअर्स, वॉट डज योर सर्वे रिजल्ट, हाउ डज इट जस्टिफाई दिस?
सी, what we observed on the ground in the survey is that a certain section of voters who had become indecisive, now these were BJP voters who had become indecisive, saying okay, because of the partidar agitation or some other issues, okay, we want to go with the Congress, or rather we are undecided, we are not sure whether we are going with the BJP or with the Congress. Now Alpesh Thakur actually served as some sort of a disincentive for them. Moment they saw him going into the Congress, it revived the memories of the old Kham agitation as well as Alpesh saying that he was actually opposed to the Patidar reservation or the plank. So that sort of repolarized back to the late 90s situations where the Patidars and other castes did not prefer going with the Congress, which was deemed to be representing the other castes, which they were not comfortable with. So actually this reverse polarization took place, and that seemed to be adding to the BJP. And even historically...
Well, reverse polarization, on that note, let's get the reaction from Union Finance Minister, Mr. Arun Jaitley, who's joining me on the News Hour tonight, live and direct. Mr. Arun Jaitley, this is the survey result. You are the in charge of the Gujarat elections. The survey results indicate that the BJP wave, despite much of what has been said and written, is still very much in favor of the BJP, despite the anti-incumbency factor. What is your assessment of the factors that you believe are contributing to the mood in Gujarat? The question here is also about the fact, Mr. Arun Jaitley, that Narendra Modi going out of Gujarat and becoming the prime minister hasn't really converted BJP into a Congress bastion.
Well, let's be clear, since 1994, we've been continuously winning Gujarat. Except for a brief period when Mr. Wagela crossed over and became a chief minister, we've been in government in Gujarat. Gujarat has seen political stability, and Gujarat has seen unprecedented economic development. Post 2002, Gujarat has also seen a lot of social harmony, notwithstanding the background of what happened in 2002. Now, people in Gujarat remember that there was an era of power cuts. Today, it's an age of power surplus. They remember Gujarat where caste riots in the 80s used to take place. Today there is a perfect social harmony. Globally, the Gujarat model is touted as one of the good models of economic development. It's a highly industrialized state. It's got a world-class infrastructure developing. It's got a large manufacturing base. It's always had traditional trading, and of course the township development in Gujarat is unprecedented. A very large part of Gujarat has become urban, and I think with every election BJP has been maintaining a reasonable amount of vote bank, notwithstanding the desperate tactics that Congress tries to maintain in every election, which in the last few days we've seen they're trying to do that in Gujarat also.
But Mr. Jaitley, that's the real point. The caste cowboys, Hardik Patel, Jignesh Mevani and Alpesh Thakur are here. Does this show it's the BJP getting nervous, or is it really the Congress's desperation that it's going in for this kind of a rainbow alliance with all these caste factors?
Some of them are congressmen in disguise. They didn't own up to a Congress relationship. One of them has clearly owned it up. The other has been conducting midnight parleys with the Congress party. But their object really is to help the Congress party. Why are they doing it surreptitiously? The reason is very clear. You use the word caste cowboys. You see, when you indulge in excessive caste politics, then you end up alienating a large number of social groups against you. Now, look at what has happened to the Bahujan Samaj Party in Uttar Pradesh. It's a party which relied heavily on caste and eventually ended up rallying multiple castes against itself. And therefore, if you rely excessively on caste politics, will it help you or will it hurt you? I think the Gujarat election is going to squarely and fairly answer that question.
But Mr. Jaitley, you talk of surreptitious meetings between Hardik Patel and Rahul Gandhi, but they allege that your government in Gujarat has put them under surveillance and leaked the CCTV footage to the media. They also question the non-bailable warrants that have been issued against Hardik Patel, which are coming after 2.5 years of the original complaint. All this is time to the elections?
Well, that's between him and the court. Let's be very clear, it's not been issued by the police, it's been issued by a court. Obviously, he must be having some case pending in a court which he would not have complied with. If I decide to defy a court, the court will issue a bailable warrant or a non-bailable warrant against me. I can't try and cry foul on that basis. There is a due process of law everybody has to comply with. Now, as far as the CCTV footage is concerned, if you hold a meeting in a star hotel where there are security cameras, obviously you are going to be seen. You are going to be recorded on those security cameras. Now, if you are taking the chance of holding these midnight parleys, I believe one of the strengths of Indian democracy is nothing remains a secret. And these do come out in course of time.
And the CCTV footage leakage, Mr. Jaitley, why are you shying away from answering that question?
Well, according to me, there is no evidence of that allegation. And let me assume it, to say my opponents are doing it is a favorite argument which every politician uses. That allegation doesn't prove anything. The fact of the matter is, did you or did you not have a surreptitious meeting? That's the end of the matter. Please own it up. Don't be a congressman in disguise. Have the courage and capacity to say, I am a congressman, I was batting for the Congress, I am now taking the veil off.
But Mr. Jaitley, my last question to you, how do you see Rahul Gandhi's future after the elections of Himachal Pradesh and Gujarat? If these surveys are anything to go by, you seem to be getting Gujarat in your account. What does this mean for Rahul Gandhi?
Well, I think he has a very bright future. He's a leader of a party because where his rise in the party is inversely proportionate to the success of the party. The party fails in every election. His position in the party becomes stronger after every election. I think it's a strange political relationship between him and the party and the electoral results. They have an inverse proportionality relationship.
Well, thank you very much for joining me, Mr. Jaitley. It's Bob versus Bob. It's Gabbar Singh tax versus success of Rahul Gandhi inversely proportional to the success of the Congress party. Thank you very much, Mr. Jaitley, for joining me here on the News Hour tonight on our Big Times Now VMR survey results. Let me go back to the debate. Let me get in Ghanshyam Tiwari. Ghanshyam Tiwari, the moot question is, if Rahul Gandhi, जो आपके मित्र हैं, जो समाजवादी पार्टी के अलायंस पार्टनर हैं उत्तर प्रदेश के दिनों से, why is he doing surreptitious meetings with Hardik Patel? If he wants to go ahead with Hardik Patel, why the first kabhi haan kabhi na with Alpesh Thakur? Why the late night meetings in hotels with Hardik Patel with denials coming from both sides? Why all of this secrecy?
Well, I thought Mr. Jaitley would answer that because he knows how these footages are leaked out. I have never seen Mr. Jaitley's footage leaked out when he speaks as if it is usual that footages like this get leaked out all the time and truth comes out.
So there was some sort of denial and unease in that question. And he spoke about Gujarat model. I want to tell you what the Gujarat model. The Scroll publishes it that Gujarat ranks in top 5 states on per capita income, availability of power, growth for the past 3 decades. But where does Gujarat rank on any of the social indicators? The greatest criticism of Gujarat model is that at one end, it's a state that has done well on all the economic indicators and infrastructure indicators, but done poorly, inexplicably poorly on all the social indicators, right from literacy to gender ratio to health and whatnot. So the Gujarat
sir,
model is nothing to
Gandhi pe jawab dena.
Gabbar Singh tax
if,
is the architecture
if the survey
of
is to be believed, Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari, if this survey is to be believed, Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari, and Jayam Rukh stands by the survey that he's conducted, the fact is that despite anti-incumbency, despite demo, despite GST, Mr. Rahul Gandhi has trivialized every reform in this country, but he still can't win an election. Isn't that something that you should be responding to, Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari? Let me ask that question to Dr. Fuad Haleem, because you wanted to rattle off indices. We are asking about Rahul Gandhi.
Let me complete the response. In August, a survey said that BJP will get 58% vote share. Today's surveys are saying that they are going to get 48% or lesser vote share. There is a consistent slide. When you see a listless chief minister like Mr. Vijay Rupani talking about Alpesh Thakur's father and his family history, it shows that how edgy BJP is. The entire youth brigade in Gujarat is with the Congress, and the Hardik Patel or Alpesh Thakur or Jignesh Mevani are not age-old leaders. These are young leaders. They don't know the stories of 90s. These are leaders that emerged in the story of today. And where is BJP in the story of today? Since the Prime Minister, BJP has had 2 chief ministers.
BJP is not in the story of today. You think Rahul Gandhi is, Dr. Fuad Haleem? BJP is not in the story of today. Do you think Rahul Gandhi is in the story of today? And how do you respond?
Ghanshyam ji.
How do you respond to Mr. Arun Jaitley's remark? Will Rahul Gandhi still be promoted as president despite the forecast of victory being absolutely out of reach of Rahul Gandhi in Gujarat?
If
that question is for me, I'll answer it.
Yes, please go on.
Now, if I look at the figures that you have given, Navika, I think so they are incomplete, because in 2015 there was a panchayat election held in Gujarat. And if we look at those figures, then the Bharatiya Janata Party, as compared to 2010, they went down from 30 district panchayats to 6 district panchayats, and taluka panchayats, they went down from 150 to 67. Their voting percentages went down from 51% to 44% in the district panchayat, and the taluka panchayat, they lost from 49% to 42%. So the last election on a large scale held in Gujarat, in 2015, which is the last figures that should have come on your screen, a little bit of research would have helped, shows that the BJP has definitely lost ground at the village level and the Gram Panchayat elections.
Now you're clinging at straws.
That, there are two
they are
that
performing better than they performed in 2012, sir. Why don't you respond on Rahul Gandhi, or is
we
Rahul Gandhi a blind support for the opposition party?
And local bodies election and municipal corporation election.
Navika, had you put the figures for the panchayat elections, then definitely it would have been considered a balanced analysis of the elections that have taken place in Gujarat. But you have
Mr.
not put the panchayat elections.
Then you should also mention how many panchayats were contested on
and
the party symbol.
Sudhanshu Tiwari, please talk in your own time. Please talk in
have
your
you
own time.
Have you mentioned the by-elections?
Let us understand.
The municipal corporation elections
makes a comments.
And above all, the figure which is coming in the survey.
Yes, I want all the figures to be there. Sudhanshu Tiwari, you accept that you have lost the district panchayat and the taluka panchayat.
So when
you
have panchayat elections?
The other by-elections you keep on
Sabha Nakvi. Sabha Nakvi.
Is
the opposition...
This is an incomplete analysis.
Yeah.
Let me finish. Navika,
yeah,
please,
because there are no
finish.
Panchayat elections. You want me to compare panchayat elections to the assembly elections?
let me finish. Navika, please be kind enough. I have been listening to everybody. I just want to finish. Even Sudhanshu Trivedi accepts that your analysis is incomplete because the by-elections are also not there. So I agree with him. It's an incomplete analysis. Now, coming to the two comments I would like to make very clearly, there is an allegation of a huge amount of money being transferred by the BJP to an individual, and that individual has categorically called a press conference and made that comment. The Bharatiya Janata Party in government, both at the state level and at the central level, including the finance minister who spoken today, has not taken cognizance of that. You know, demonetization, the very understanding of demonetization, large notes in large amounts moving around in the black murky scenario over here. The BJP is the center of the allegation, and you don't have the state government, the central government, and the finance minister responding to it. It's the failure of demonetization and the allegation against the BJP. Let's be very clear about that. That huge amount of black money is going to be used by the BJP, and this is the tip of the iceberg.
Well,
they are in power, they are not taking cognizance of it.
Well, you talked about demonetization in the Uttar Pradesh election. Sabha Naqvi. Sabha Naqvi, the opposition criticized the demo move. They continue to tell the BJP that the BJP would be routed completely in Uttar Pradesh. And what happened? Today, when these survey results are showing that the BJP is gaining vote percentage in Gujarat. Do you think once again the demo argument is going to work in Gujarat Sabha?
Navika, if you just give me some 2 minutes, I've actually covered 3 elections in Gujarat. So the easy thing is to say that obviously Mr. Jaitley is absolutely right. This is a gad of the BJP beyond any gad. Ye asli gad to Gujarat hai. Theek hai now. But the BJP obviously goes into this election with every advantage. I'm not arguing about that. What is of interest to me, if you will bear with me, we know what the 2000 campaign, in what context it took place. In 2007, Narendra Modi started the terminology of Delhi Sultanate. And I've just been going through my own notes for something I'm writing, where he said, Delhi se hame kuch nahi chahiye. He blamed everything on Delhi Sultanate. And that was 2007, and that's when the Modi masks came out also in Gujarat. 2012 was like a rock concert. It was a riveting campaign. I mean, it was almost thrilling to watch it. This was the Vivekanand theme was used. There were bike riders, there were drums, there were bands, and Narendra Modi would come there, and again he would talk about the Gujarati pride versus Delhi. So now he was able to tap something called the sub-nationalism of Gujarati pride. Now he's entering a campaign. I'm going tomorrow to Gujarat. He's entering a campaign after we have had some very large scale economic changes within India, and he is the Prime Minister now. He cannot tap Gujarati sub-nationalism against Delhi. We have to accept that. So from the little that I've watched on television and all, the campaign, Mr. Modi's campaign does not seem to have that cult character that his campaigns in Gujarat had. I'm making an observation here. So I'm curious to see how it will pick up now. Navika, in Uttar Pradesh, it's not even a fair comparison, because in Uttar Pradesh the BJP had not been in power for years and years and years. In Gujarat, this is their absolute guard. So I think we need to watch this campaign because this is actually the first election where
I've never seen you shying away. From numbers. The numbers of the survey actually give the BJP a better performance. Now, are you saying that the caste cowboy combination has boomeranged on Rahul Gandhi already? Because that motley group of caste combinations is something that Gujarat isn't
that.
Really keen on. It's,
I'm not. Navika, it's
so
too
what,
early.
Question for Sabha, I have an additional question.
It's too early, Navika. It is very easy. You know, Gujarat BJP has been almost like a brick wall which the Congress could not. The Congress
absolutely
has not
Sabha,
had
that
a narrative
is my question.
In Gujarat.
For the last
election
three
after election, one is not talking about that. I am just giving you, I am raising questions about what phase of Narendra Modi's journey, what phase of his own history from Gujarat we are in right now. But I think it's too early. I think this election is a work in progress. And I think a 6,000 sample is too small to come out with definitive conclusions. I believe I have been calling up the same people who are showing.
Defend your numbers. Jayamrukh wants to defend his numbers. Jayamrukh wants to come in. Jayamrukh
will be closer.
Yeah, okay. I just have I just want a few observations. I mean, I'm not saying this to stir a debate. I just want a few observations from Sabha. I greatly respect
her. But you must.
Very well-traveled journalist. She's observed the BJP. She's observed the BJP for many elections. Sabha, what would you comment on the BJP as an election machinery in Gujarat vis-a-vis the Congress? See, because I was speaking, you know, the Communist Party Marxist leader, I'm sorry, I don't get his name, just immediately after those panchayat elections, you know, I was speaking to a Congress leader, you know, and without naming him, he confided in me that, you know, look, even if these election results have not been so favorable to the BJP, yet they will make it because their last mile, the last day, the booth management and all, that machinery is far excellent. So I just want to know, what is your observation and comment about that election machinery of the BJP?
Absolutely.
That's all.
Absolutely. And let me, I will entirely agree with you. That is a huge advantage that the BJP has. I'll also share with you that, for, you know, some people would know this, but every election, there would be some dissidents from the BJP ever since Narendra Modi went to Gujarat, who would be siding with the Congress. And every election, the media would make a lot of it, but nothing would come of it. And I actually never thought anything would come of it. In fact, it was 2012 Gujarat where I started to do television with Times Now. And everybody jumped on me because I said, this state cannot be touched by these dissidents, are not going to make any difference in 2012. But I'm just pointing, to me, that is a very critical point, that Narendra Modi tapped sub-nationalism of Gujarat. He cannot make those speeches about Delhi Sultanate against Delhi right now. I'm just curious
well,
about that.
Well, that may be so, Sabha. I've covered Narendra Modi in the 2007 and 2012 elections. And 2007, it was to me that he responded in an interview when the entire Maut Ka Saudagar controversy had taken place. Yes, that is something that's not there. But then Gujaratis and their pride, the fact that one of their own is actually the Prime Minister of India, can you take that factor away? And let me get in Kumar Ketkar. Mr. Kumar Ketkar, you've covered several elections. Mr. Kumar Ketkar, how do you see this heavy reliance this time by the Congress party on a motley group of caste combinations? Is that going to work in a in a arithmetic alliance where everything will be an addition, or do you think the Alpesh Thakur vote bank doesn't quite doesn't become quite compatible with the Hardik Patel vote bank that he brings to the table? Aren't there contradictions within these two vote banks itself?
Navika, if you are asking me, are you asking me? Navika.
Yes, I'm asking you.
Navika, who are you addressing the question?
For you, Kumar Ketkar.
Yeah. Then the simple point is, let us not compare the election machinery and the election preparation by the BJP with the Congress. The first thing is, Rahul was never a chief ministerial candidate in Gujarat and has not been a prime minister at all and not been a candidate. So we are comparing a person with 12 years of chief ministership of Gujarat with a person who has not been even for 1 minute minister anywhere. Moreover, the same chief minister now for 3 years has been a prime minister. So what is on test is Prime Minister Modi as well as Chief Minister Modi of the earlier 12 years. Now the vote is not exactly a referendum. Nobody is necessarily questioning that the BJP is definitely going to lose or definitely going to win. The simple question is, if Modi was so popular, such a cult figure, that for 12 years he controlled Gujarat and now he's controlling whole of India as a Prime Minister, his vote share is expected to substantially grow, which is not growing. From your own figures and from your own past figures also, earlier elections from 2007 to 2012, there is a decline.
But sir, I don't know which figures you are looking at.
To 2012,
in 2012, the BJP had a vote share of 48%, and now it's 52%. It's a 4% increase.
These comparisons are absurd. These comparisons are false. And you are trying to make this comparison only to show Rahul as a very lesser kind of a person. I don't think that is required. You have have the numbers with you, you have the percentages with you, and Modi also can win perhaps the BJP, but the fact that Modi is actually losing.
Oh, so the shield comes out for Rahul Gandhi. 2012,
and now let us not underestimate the impact of GST, the negative impact of GST. It was Narendra Modi who said that even if the whole country accepts GST, Gujarat will not. I will not let GST come. The same mindset prevails in the trading community in Gujarat. Trading community in Gujarat is up in arms because they were supporting Modi, opposing GST. And now suddenly
Sudhanshu Trivedi, Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi.
So let us
Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi, let's take up the point that Mr. Kumar Kedkar has put out. He says you can't compare Rahul Gandhi and Narendra Modi. Why can't we compare Rahul Gandhi and Narendra Modi? After all, Rahul Gandhi is the vice president of the Congress. He makes all the decisions in the Congress party. He is going to be the next prime ministerial candidate of the Congress party in the 2019 election. Why should Modi not be compared to Rahul Gandhi? Or why should Rahul Gandhi be given a discount because he's never been a prime minister or a chief minister?
Let us not ignore some
aspects. No, I'm not. But you are trying to deliberately ignore. You are trying to deliberately ignore. You are trying to deliberately ignore Rahul Gandhi's own stature.
Because Narendra Modi proved to be an asset for BJP and asset for the country.
And asset
and
is losing.
Rahul Gandhi in the last 15-16 years proved to be a liability on the Congress and also on the country.
Mr. Sudhanshu, asset is declining. Asset
Kumar
is declining
Ketkaji,
in its
this is
value.
Just an initiation.
See that
wait for the culmination of the election. It is still almost 1.5 month away. Abhi to ye
own figures
hai. Anjaam tak inzaam kariye. Tasveer aur saaf ho
jayegi.
And one more thing, as far as the electoral machinery is concerned, I would like to remind that as far as the commencement of booth committees are concerned,
the question is not Rahul versus Modi.
In the BJP organization is completed
BJP
all booth committees. I think it was around 1,60,000 or something.
We
in 2007.
Rahul and Modi.
So that's why our network and the organization and the booth level is quite strong. Obviously, we are the cadre-based party.
But I am not
and
saying
Congress
BJP
is
not
a leader-based party.
I never said that.
Which has become leaderless party.
I never
in,
said Congress will come to power. I never said Rahul will come to power.
About the three
I am merely
youth
questioning your proposition.
अरे
I am merely questioning your statement that Modi is a cult figure is so popular that he will be able to win the seat.
And as far as the
Modi is losing the seat, Modi is not winning the seat. And Modi's hypocrisy,
I would like to remind,
Modi's hypocrisy is now known to the trading community of Gujarat.
Gentlemen, let's not speak over each other.
And that's why Surat traders
are not speak over each other. Mr. Kumar Kedkar, Mr. Kumar Kedkar, Mr. Kumar Kedkar, you made a point, allow Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi to respond.
The traders in Surat did not Mr. Let me say something on my turn.
Okay, got your point, Mr. Kumar Kedkar. Allow.
Slogans against
Modi. You made that point three times.
Against the BJP.
You made that.
So traders are more against Modi than against BJP.
Mr. Kumar Kedkar, allow Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi to now respond to the facts that you have raised. Yes, Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi.
Kumar Kedkar ji has raised the issue of. Dissatisfaction in the traders on the issue of GST. Yes, of course, when there is a huge decision is taken in the transition state, there are certain problems which the government is aware. That's why I am saying your survey must be at least 2 or 3 weeks before. So the impact of Prime Minister's decision which he has taken on GST or on other related things, their impact would not have come reflected in this survey. So that's why I am saying, let the time pass and the things will gradually become more and more synchronous and the people will understand the advantage of GST, and by the time the polling day will come, we will definitely will see that all the traders and all the communities were totally in support of BJP as they were in the past. And now coming on the issue of Gujarati pride with the Sabha has raised. Yes, I would like to remind, it was the Congress party which had not allowed Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel to become Prime Minister despite 17 out of 18 Congress committee was supporting them in 47. It was the Congress party who has put down the second Prime Minister from Gujarat, Morarji Desai, and not allowed them to complete the full term. And it is the Congress party which has the third stalwart leader, Shri Narendra Modi. He has become Prime Minister and still they are keep on slinging mud on and try to demean or belittle his image, which is going unaffected. So Congress party is consistently proved to be against the pride of Gujarat. And as far as the Delhi Sultanate is concerned, अरे मैं तो कहना चाहता हूँ Sabaji, वो Delhi Sultanate थी सही बात है, which was remembered in history for loot, tyranny and massacre. अब वो Delhi Sultanate विक्रमादित्य के सिंहासन में बदल गई है, and which is now all set to take India into the golden age of Guptas. तो वो दिल्ली सल्तनत भी थी, गुजराती प्राइड भी था, वो सारा का सारा नजारा बदल चुका है एज फार एज द नेशनल प्राइड इज कंसर्न, एंड गुजरात इज ऑल सेट टू गो अलोंग विद इंडिया इन द न्यू 21st सेंचुरी. और लास्ट में मैं ये भी कहना चाहूंगा, जो अरुण जेटली जी ने कहा, भाई अल्पेश ठाकुर वो कांग्रेस के थे मगर फिर भी अभी जानते हैं कांग्रेस की आदत नहीं गई. अल्पेश ठाकुर की वापसी जानते क्या है? इट इज घर वापसी, मगर घर वापसी को धर्म परिवर्तन कह रहे हैं. अरे भाई 2 साल पहले भी कहते थे, अब तो बदल दीजिए ना. मान लीजिए वो घर वापसी है, धर्म परिवर्तन नहीं, पर आप उस माइंडसेट से बाहर ही रहिए.
भाषा कौन इस्तेमाल करता है? धर्म परिवर्तन से ये आपकी आपकी स्पीच नहीं है. आई वांट टू टेल सुधांशु त्रिवेदी क्लियरली, व्हेन नविका यू से काउबॉयज, द ओनली पार्टी इन इंडिया हुज हुज गाय की पार्टी काउ पॉलिटिक्स इज बीजेपी.
आप कह रहे हैं धर्म परिवर्तन,
सुधांशु यू मस्ट रीड योर हिस्ट्री ऑफ
पॉलिटिक्स एंड गोबर गवर्नेंस.
मोरारजी देसाई गवर्नमेंट
बिजी प्लेइंग चीफ मिनिस्टर Gujarat because there is a listless chief minister in Gujarat. Three, if you look at Google Trends, I call upon Jay Murg to also look at Google Trends. If you look at Google Trends, leaders like Hardik Patel or Jignesh or Alpesh are much more popular than leaders in BJP. And today, after all this discussion, we are missing one man. The invisible man in Gujarat is...
So that's why I'm Ghanshyam Tiwari. Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari, I can't believe it that a party like the Samajwadi Party, which criticized the BJP for trying to dominate social media, is now fighting Gujarat elections on Google Trends? Are you fighting Gujarat elections on Google Trends, Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari? That's exactly what you used to criticize the BJP for.
You can see it. See, it's you can see it. No, I'm not saying that. You can see the voter intent, young voter intent in capture is.
No, he's having Twitter and Google friends from Kazakhstan and all over the world.
Now there are data in Gujarat. You can use Gujarat data to figure out in Gujarat what are people searching for. They are searching for Hardik Patel, what Hardik Patel said, did not say. They are searching for Alpesh. They are searching for Thakur.
My
so this
God.
Is what people are looking for, because BJP has a whole set of leaders have a vision to put forward to.
That is why Ms. Are these Google trends going to determine the elections of Gujarat, Sabha Naqvi? As a journalist who's covered several elections, Sabha Naqvi, do you think Google Trends is going to take...
It is a sentiment to like
your allow Sabha Naqvi to respond to you, Ghanshyam Tiwari. Allow Sabha Naqvi to comment. Sabha Naqvi, Google Trends are going to determine the Gujarat elections?
Ghanshyam, please. Not at all, Navika. I think Ghanshyam is making a very... Ghanshyam, don't mind it. You're making a very childish point. If there are Google search for these people, because people need to find out who they are.
You don't understand technology, Sabha.
I'm not... You know, people need to find out who they are. They're suddenly in the news. Allow me to speak. Please allow me to speak. People are searching for them, not because they want to... People are going to check out tomorrow. We are talking in Gujarat.
In Gujarat.
Either somebody lets me speak, Ghanshyam. Ghanshyam, I have not spoken very much. I don't speak very much. So allow me if you'd let me. It's not terribly relevant what you're talking. We are looking at the complete gut of the Bharatiya Janata Party. All right? At a time when Gujarati is a prime minister. Yes, things are happening on the ground. I think this election, there's a process which has begun. And we'll really have to watch. But we are talking about a gut, so don't make it about silly things like Google search. You know, elections in India can yield surprises.
It's not,
but
Sabha, if you don't anyway, understand something, we'll don't call it silly.
People are checking on everything.
I don't
but there is
idea.
A point
you,
about the Carter, there is
a
point.
It's a sentiment tool, you don't
absolutely.
Understand it.
Well, let's not pinprick each other first.
Unke American salaahkar aur
I don't think that's an indicator.
Dharti putra se jo the dharti pe aa gaye. धरती पुत्र के पुत्र होकर
अलीमुद्दीन खान साहब, अलीमुद्दीन खान साहब, आप जवाब दीजिए कि यहाँ से कहाँ जाएंगे राहुल गांधी अगर ये सर्वे, अगर ये सर्वे सही हो जाता है जिसमें कांग्रेस पार्टी के जो सीट्स हैं वो 49 to 61 सीट्स हैं. What happens to Rahul Gandhi after this? Are you still going to crown him as the president of the Congress party on the 19th of November? Or will you wait for the 18th of December to see whether he can deliver Himachal Pradesh and Gujarat to the Congress party at all?
Navika, only one point, one correction needed. Sudhanshu said Congress
Navika
brought
ji,
down
first
the Moradi Desai
Rahul
government.
Gandhi is going to become
it
president
was Charan
of the party.
Singh, his
there is no
doubt in
this. There is no question mark on this. And Charan as far as Rahul Gandhi ji rising is concerned, he has rise to that level that even the Jain community,
Congress
which belong
did not
to Amit Shah and Ruru and Vijay.
Charan Singh and the socialist.
Let me speak, sir. Let me speak, sir. It is my turn, sir. Sir, it's my turn, sir. Sir, sir, it's my turn. Even Vijay Rupani is going to lose his elections. Even Jain community is backing Rahul Gandhi to that level that Amit Shah has got 10%. Chief Minister candidate rate in survey. Do you know that? That's why it was intelligent move of Amit Shah. He has run away from the Gujarat to save his skin. And Rahul Gandhi ji has risen to that level that now Narendra Modi will not get a space to hide himself.
So
people
you
of
agree?
Gujarat will change
you
in
agree?
Every, in every state. Election by election, vote by vote.
You agree with Mr. Arun Jaitley? Do you agree with Mr. Arun Jaitley who says अगर राहुल गांधी की पार्टी खराब करती है तो राहुल गांधी की प्रमोशन होती है? क्या ये इस बार फिर वैसे ही होगा कि राहुल गांधी हारेंगे गुजरात के इलेक्शन और उनकी प्रमोशन हो जाएगी, प्रेसिडेंट बन जाएंगे?
नहीं नाविका, राहुल तैयार है अध्यक्ष बनने के लिए.
जी, राहुल गांधी गोइंग टू बिकम प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द पार्टी वेरी सून. नंबर वन. नंबर टू, हिज स्ट्रेटजी इज वर्किंग इन गुजरात. Congress going to win election in Gujarat. Congress is going to get 150 seats in Gujarat.
Okay. Mr. Okay. Last comment to Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi.
Rajkot West is going to lose himself. He cannot win even his own election.
Okay. Last.
The Chief Minister is not.
Last point. Last point to Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi. Sudhanshu Trivedi.
Let Sudhanshu Trivedi answer. Who toppled Morarji Desai government?
Gujarat has always played a major role in creating history of the country. When the history is being created at Delhi, definitely Gujarat has to be not only in tune but on the forefront, and this election will prove this.
All right, it's the BJP that's leading the race in the Gujarat elections. Gujarat Modi verdict. Yes, that's the top trend on Twitter. And the survey shows that BJP will get anything between 118 to 134 seats in Gujarat. Modi continues to hold his magic on Gujarat. Rahul Gandhi, despite his caste cowboy combination, seems to be really finishing off anywhere between 49 and 61 seats. What will this mean for Rahul Gandhi? Will it mean another promotion when his party's prospects are going down? That's a question that the Congress needs to answer. Thank you very much to all my panelists for joining me here on the News Hour at 9. The News Hour at 10 coming up with Anand Narasimhan on the other side. Stay tuned. Don't go away.